So we need to take this message seriously and pray. Amen.
On the 1st of January 2018, during the prophetic crossover service at Divine Kingdom Baptist Ministries, the servant of God, Pastor Ian Ndlovu, gave a prophetic warning to the nation of Kenya, urging saints and intercessors to pray for peace. These were his words.
Let us pray against any disturbances to peace and tranquility. Unless senior political leaders find themselves at the negotiating table for the sake of peace and progress, I see by the Holy Spirit the devil release a spirit of belligerence and pride which may lead to bloodshed, detentions and exile for some. Let us pray and watch for peace in Kenya. This message pertains to Kenya. Hallelujah. Because I saw the devil release some frogs. You know frogs? Frogs. I saw an evil spirit in the realms of the spirit, in the atmosphere, on top of Kenya, release some frogs. And these frogs were accosting some opposition leaders there in Kenya. Accosting them, I mean, you know, doing stuff to them so that they become belligerent. Because in any nation there is authority. Say, in any nation there is authority. You can't just do as you please. I cannot organize an inauguration ceremony at Nkuluman 12 there and then inaugurate myself as president. If I do that, it will lead to a lot of violence. Hallelujah. It may lead to bloodshed. I saw that the Spirit of God is saying we must arrest, because this thing is happening at the spiritual realm. It's not something which is happening at the physical realm. That the devil has released some frog-like spirits which will create belligerence among some leaders in the opposition. I'm not mentioning any names, but we must pray for our Kenyan brothers and sisters to find each other at the negotiating table so that they can forge a path of consensus, a path of oneness and unity for the sake of peace and the progress of that country. Because there may be a very brief period of very serious conflict and bloodshed unless we watch and pray. Obviously, to whatever the enemy may accost certain people in the opposition to do against the incumbent government there, it will not succeed, but it may actually damage the reputation of their nation. Hallelujah. Because I saw some leaders go to exile. I saw some leaders detained. I saw some people, losing life and limb in Kenya. So we must watch and pray for peace. Look at your neighbor and say, watch and pray for peace in Kenya. There is also a spiritual awakening which God is stirring there in Kenya. That's why there is this confusion that the devil wants to bring about. Because God is raising men and women of God who are part of the team that will herald the coming of Jesus Christ in this end time. Who will herald the coming of Jesus Christ in this end time with the power and the anointing of the resurrection life of Jesus Christ. Let us clap hands for God. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, pray for Kenya.
Raila Odinga is expected to take place in due course. We are now joined by the Homa Bay Woman Representative, Honorable Gladys Wanga. Mheshimiwa, thank you very much for accepting to speak to us. What can you update us in terms of arrangements so far?
I think it's a beautiful day. You can feel the excitement in the air. Everything is in place. We are expecting the guests to be moving in here in the next hour. The day is a very, very significant day for the people of Kenya, because we are breaking loose from the shackles of injustice that Jubilee has put us under. And we are very, 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 very excited as a people, as NASA people, and we congratulate on this auspicious occasion His Excellency Raila Odinga, His Excellency Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka.
Earlier there were indications that such a move to swear in Raila Odinga would attract the charge of treason. What will be your take on that?
As our president said, we are ready for the consequences. We are doing the right thing. We are within the law, but we are ready for the consequences. If it is imprisonment, bring it on. If it is jail for life, If it is death, bring it on. We are ready.
Raila power.
The servant of God, Pastor Ian Ndlovu, urges saints and intercessors the world over to continue to pray for the consensus, unity and peace in the nation of Kenya. 1 Timothy 2 verse 1 and 2 says, I urge then first of all that petitions, prayers, intercession and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. May the Almighty God bless you.